Kate Masso, you're in Ridgewood chasing the story of the guy who stole 2 million quarters. What happened?
Yeah, Bill, they say that a quarter can't buy you anything these days, but these add up. Just ask former Ridgewood Public Works Inspector Thomas Rica. According to prosecutors, he stole $460,000 in parking meter quarters from a room at Village Hall. That's 23,000 pounds of change. And he's now been sentenced after pleading guilty to third-degree theft. So what's the penalty for a public employee who steals almost 500 grand from the village? Well, in Rica's case, it's 5 years probation, and he has to pay back just under 250 grand, and that's about half of what they believe he stole. I hit the streets of Ridgewood to talk to the people, and they say they think the crime is outrageous, and so is the sentence.
Kind of seems a little crazy.
I think it is terrible that he is not getting any jail time whatsoever.
He should pay it all in pennies, and he should count them one by one.
So why did he get off so easy? The state only charged him with third-degree theft. If they charged him with a more serious offense, second-degree theft, then he would be on his way to jail right now.
You know what bothers me about this? There are thousands of people who are locked up in prison right now because they stole a damn candy bar, or they stole something relatively minor, and you threw the book at them. This guy stole $500,000 at least over a period of time, is not going to jail, and only has to pay back half. That's not a punishment. That's a reward.
Somebody's got to speak up for the guy. Why not?
I'll speak up
for the guy, and I'll use the exact same reasons Anderson did. He stole $500,000. He's paying back 225 of it, whatever it is, and he doesn't have to go to jail. Which way to Ridgewood?